This is Duke University.
You mentioned earlier that America is losing its competitive edge, and you were talking about the role education plays in that.
Yeah.
So what skills are American students lacking, and what do they need to know in order to compete in a global workplace?
First of all, they need to work harder. We work hard in our work life, but I'm not sure we work hard enough in our student life. I've never found an undergraduate who's really overworked. MIT, there's a possibility at MIT and Caltech, there's a marginal possibility, but the reality is that we're quite leisurely about, especially before college. So it seems to me hard work and discipline is something that has been eroded in American youth culture.
Which is interesting because American students are still suffering from anxiety, depression, and stress.
That's all journalism. I think that's that's journalism for a limited part of the upper middle class. I think, you know, and if their anxiety is because the school leaves them in the lurch, they're all on their own. I mean, life, welcome to anxiety. Life, the idea of living without anxiety is an American disease, the notion that life is painless. You know? There's no aspirin for life, no Advil. And if it exists, it wears off. And that is the illusion of all drug-taking populations. You know, I understand why they take drugs, because life is hard. And the dealing with life requires strength. And learning and skill is part of that strength. So if you ask me what Americans lack, it's discipline, hard work, concentration, sustained effort, and a long-term view. Not short-term gratification, not in and out quick. Build a company, sell it tomorrow, bingo, I'm out. But a long-term commitment to an idea, to a product, to a business. And also a sense of obligation that connects their well-being to that of the community. So not only about individual stars, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, but has to do with how my success connects to the betterment of my community. So a sense of social obligation that corresponds to the cult of the individual. So I think that, but in terms of educational virtues and a greater, we have failed to cultivate the most natural interests of children. Children, when all of you who've been parents and all of you who remember your childhood, what interests you most is the natural universe. You want to know why the sun sets. It doesn't actually set, but why it seems that the sun sets. You want to know why the leaves turn. You want to know why you bleed. You want to know why you have a blister when it got hot. You know? You know why daddy's going bald. It's issues about real, the natural world. And that is systematically murdered by parents, by community, and by school. So we need to revive that fundamental natural interest and curiosity. The internet can help, all this can help. So there are more Americans studying science, engineering, mathematics, the areas of knowledge that actually are connected to our ability to employ our fellow Americans and to have a vibrant economy.
Produced by Duke University.